tonight. From Chicago, Soundstage. New Orleans has given today's music much more than the funky piano that has been ever present on oh so many rock hits since the 50s. The rhythms of rock are filled with the backbeat of New Orleans soul music. And ask any top rocker today to name his idols, and you can bet that Lee Dorsey, Huey Piano Smith, Professor Longhair, and the Meters will find a place somewhere. And so might Dr. John, Etta James, and Alan Toussaint. Three interpreters and creators of music so distinctive that as soon as you hear it, you know where it comes from. Tonight, on Soundstage, we give them time enough to stretch, enough room to cook, and enough comfort to work individually and collectively for a great hour of music. Ladies and gentlemen, the music of Dr. John, Etta James, and Alan Toussaint.
Thank you. I don't know exactly when we actually first met, but it was back in those days, that maybe in the, somewhere in the 50s.
Yeah.
I'd say around the time maybe Etta had a record about Tough Lover that she cut down there or something. And we all, a lot of things were happening in New Orleans around that time. Alan was working at the Dew Drop. Etta was working in New Orleans. We all were like, you know, hustling in the record industry and in the music business and any other way it's possible. But that's the, I don't know exactly when that was, but I know that's about the times that I could say.
my fill to talk into this town. Need a little brain salad surgery. Got to cure this insecurity. Been in the right place, been wrong down. Been in the right world, you the wrong man. Been in the right bank, been wrong on. In the right place, what's going wrong, 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 wrong.
If there would have been the kind of music that we just take for granted today, if Etta hadn't have been doing what she was doing in her, from the early days she was recording for the Harris Brothers and other various labels from way back in the game till now, she opened the door for that, what you're talking about, that crossover between gospel and rhythm and blues. She's kind of one of the originators of that. That I think that you wouldn't have so many people doing that very churchy thing in mixing it up with funky music or rhythm and blues music like you do today if Etta hadn't been doing it, because she was very wide open with it and real not trying to disguise anything from the very jump. And I think that's one of the reasons she appealed to so many people. And even if she took the most squarest ballad, it sounded churchy and bluesy and tunes that I don't think anybody else had the nerve to touch. She turned them into songs that everybody would dig.
I'd like to do a song that I recorded like 25 years ago. And it was rock and roll then, it's rock and roll now.
A good feeling, yeah. Yeah. I get a feeling that I never, 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 never had before. No, no. Yeah. And I just wanna tell y'all. I say y'all. Oh yeah.
you another song, but everything that I said, you know, is like 15 or 20 years, you know, you weren't even born, huh? What is that, Tell Mama? Tell Mama.
One to love you and give you the world. Now you find that you've been misused. Talk to me, I'll do what you choose. I want to tell mama all about it. Tell mama what you need. Tell mama what you want. And I'll make everything all right. She'd embarrass you anywhere. Make her friends think that she didn't care.
I'd like to do a song now that I recorded on a Deep in the Night album with Warner Brothers, and it's my favorite song. Kiki D wrote the song. It's called Sugar on the Floor.
To me, still you give me your life. I toss it to one side, still you're sweeter to me.
When will I be sure? Oh, it's warm where you are, but my lips just don't burn. I feel so insecure when you try to be kind. Could I ask for more? Feel like sugar on the floor. Feel like sugar on the floor. Sugar on the floor. Looking at you now, I know you only wanna find me. Still, I need a reason to leave the past behind me. Whoa. When I turn around, you're there. Should I ask for more? Feel like sugar on the floor. Feel like I'm sugar on the floor. Sugar on the floor. Thank you.
would say that Professor Longhead was the instigator and originator of funky music, as well as just incorporating kind of Latin music and other forms into what before that was strictly kind of shuffles and other real straight and squarish music. He circulated the music and made it something totally original. And I think it had left its mark in everybody out of New Orleans.
This is a song that I wrote, and I had a, well, I didn't have a hit record with this, but it was on the flip side of Tell Mama, and Rod Stewart got it, and he did, made a hit record. I was called I'd Rather Go Blind.
Something told me that it was over, baby. Yeah. When I saw you and that girl and y'all was talking. And my soul said, go on and cry, gal. When I saw you and that same girl, and y'all was walking by. And I would rather, I'd rather be blind. Walk away. Cause I love you so much, I just don't wanna see. Oh, I don't wanna see. I love you so much, I don't wanna see you walk away.
Sitting there a minute ago thinking, baby, I was thinking about your sweet kiss and your warm embrace. When I looked down in the glass that I held to my lips and I saw the reflection of the tears falling down my face, that's when I knew I loved you and I couldn't do without you, and I'd rather be a blind girl. Baby, 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 baby.
Don't you break my heart. Mm-mm. And they all turn around. Walk around. Wonder where I'm at. Wonder what I'm doing. I'd rather be blind. See you walk away.
Don't you go, boy. Don't you go, boy. Oh, oh, I'd rather be a blind girl. Tucson. He was just a musician, you know, a side man, and he worked at a club called the Dewdrop Inn in New Orleans. And he sat back on this little raggedy piano or organ or something. And I used to see him, you know, all the time, but, you know, I didn't know that that was Alan Toussaint, you know what I'm saying? Then later, when I saw him again, when he got ready to do his album Motions, he hired me to do background vocals, and I couldn't believe this is the same. Matter of fact, I had recorded maybe a couple of his songs. And I just wanted to say that because I think that he's one of the greatest producers, writer, arranger of our time.
She eat up your lies like it's butter. Eat up your lies like apple pie. And she don't even cry. She is not a fool. She's just trying to do what her heart says to. Tells her to love you. She waits for you patiently, hoping that someday you'll see that all she really wants to be is yours and yours alone, eternity. What do you want the girl to do? Don't you know you're breaking the child in two? What you are, still she'll be your queen if you let her, if you let her. Now and then you promise all the way out things you're gone to get her, say but she knows better. And go for your show. And as she watch your promises zero, she waits for you patiently, hoping that someday you'll see that all she really wants to be is yours and yours alone eternally. What do you want the girl? With you in mind, things just ain't bad as they seem. With you in mind, I can feel my wildest dream. With you in mind, I've done so many things that love can bring. With you in mind, with you in mind, with you in mind, went out looking for the best with you in mind, 'cause you deserve nothing less. With you in mind, I can do anything, I know I can. With you in mind, with you in mind. Like a flower drinking from the falling rain, the same rain that could wash it away. Instead it gives it strength and gives it water, and before you know, another day. The mountain to the top, with you in mind, I know love's fountain will not stop. With you in mind, I can do anything, I know I can. With you in mind, with you in mind. The falling rain, the same rain that could wash it away. I love you, I trust you. It's the same thing in a slightly different way. You. I love you. I trust
Mike had the whole scope. He had the entire scope as far as I'm concerned. I first met Mike as a guitarist. However, Mike had been playing piano, I guess even longer than that, but I didn't know much about that. I met Mike as a guitarist, and he was just playing all over the place. And during those days, musicians got along very well. Like, musicians would show each other hot licks and all. And Mac was right there during the Roy Montrell days, and they would transfer licks, pass things on. And Mac was a guitarist to me, firstly.
By the way the devil. lovers, and I know. Didn't do it, but I've been doing. Don't we hurt the devil, and I know. Didn't do it, but I've been doing. By the way, the devil, and now I know. I didn't know, but I've been doing. About the way, the devil, now I know.
The reasons that gospel was sung is similar to the reason that blues was sung, as far as I'm concerned. Some gospels are sung out of a weeping heart, but with salvation in mind. And blues, I think, would be sung out of a weeping heart, but with salvation in mind, because you can sing about it still. So you'll live on. I would think the most blues is blues. If it couldn't have been sung, the person would have surely died. But since they could sing it, well, then on to the next.
That's heavy. That's heavy.
And I do think that that association with blues and gospel sort of parallel.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. But now I'm found, was blind, but now I see. T'was grace that taught my then we first.
funding for Soundstage is provided by this station and other public television stations.